गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एम आई ऑडिबल? वेरी गुड।
यार वॉइस इज लो मैम।
नाउ इट इज ओके?
यस मैम।
ग्रेट। नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल टू टर्न ऑन योर कैमरा सो दैट वी कैन बेटर इंटरेक्ट। एवरीवन टर्न ऑन योर कैमरा एंड शो मी योर फेस प्लीज। दिस इज माई फर्स्ट क्लास विथ यू ऑल। My name is Arpita. Page number 98, An Unexpected Party. Now raise your hand if you wish to read the passage. This passage is written by J.R.R. Tolkien, an extract from The Hobbit. It is taken from a novel written by J.R.R. Tolkien. Let's know about the author. John Roland Reuel Tolkien was born in 1892 in Bloemfontein, South Africa, to British parents. When he was three, his family moved back to England. Professor Tolkien was a teacher of language and student of many ancient ones, such as Old Icelandic and Old Norse and Anglo-Saxon languages that are not used anymore. These are the very old English. These are the very old language. Can you name one ancient Indian language which is very, very old? Yes, Lasapia. Unmute and speak.
Which page, ma'am?
I am in page number 98. Himansh, do you know which is the oldest language in the world?
Ma'am, Sanskrit.
It is the oldest scripted language. Correct answer. Very good, Himansh. And we rarely use Sanskrit apart from our mythological books and hymns and puja. Puja mantras, we don't use Sanskrit much, right? Similarly, this old Icelandic, old Norse and Anglo-Saxon, these are also lost language. People used to speak in these languages long, long ago. But now they don't speak no more. But he was a teacher of these languages. He wrote about an imaginary world, Middle Earth, which characters like wizards, dragons, elves and goblins. Do you know what is wizard? Who can tell me what is a wizard? Himesh again. Yes, Himesh.
Ma'am, magician.
Correct answer. And dragons, everyone know dragon, right? If you know, show me thumbs up. Whatever you know, show me thumbs up. I know everyone know dragon. What about Dia? Dia is looking tense. Dia, you don't know what is dragon? Have you ever seen? Yes, then show me thumbs up. Show the thumbs up on camera. Very good, Dia. Next, elves. Who can tell me what is a elf? These elves are very familiar, right? We have read about them in many stories like the Snow White and yes. Only Himesh is raising hand. What about other? Vishruth. Is it your name, Vishrut?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Vishrut. Can you tell us about elves? Have you read the story of Snow White? or Christmas story. Santa Claus also have elves.
No, ma'am.
And in the story of Snow White, there were 7 elves. Now you have to describe how elves look. I think Himesh, only Himesh read all this folklore.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Elves are like dwarves with long pointy ears. Yes.
Correct. So everyone must search in internet, okay? If you have time, search in internet how elves look. They're dwarves. They have very short height and very long hair, and they wear pointed hats, right? Am
yes,
I correct?
Ma'am.
And in Snow White story, there are 7 dwarfs or elves. They help Snow White, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Now let's move to the next one, goblins. What is the meaning of goblin? Who can tell? Goblins? Anyone have idea about goblins? Again, Himesh, I think Himesh read a lot of fairy tale, right, Himesh? He knows everything, I guess. Okay, what is goblin, Himesh?
Goblins are like dwarves, with their magicians who are short in height.
Yes, goblins, we can say ghosts or monsters, okay, and they know magic, they do magic on people. And again, dwarves, hobbits, we are little hairy creature. Hobbits are little hairy creature. Hobbits are but one of the many races of Middle Earth. Middle Earth means the author imagined Earth as a place. Where do we live? We live on the surface of the Earth. So the author imagined a land which is situated at the middle of the earth. Down below the ground, there is another world where live all these mysterious creatures. Okay. His second book, Lord of the Rings, has been made into a series of films. How many of you know about Lord of the Rings? Show me thumbs up if you have seen the movie. It was a very famous movie. It won Oscars also, Lord of the Rings. Okay, can you tell me one novel name which was made into movies? From which movies are made? Shishira. Is it Shishira? What is your name?
Shishira, ma'am.
Yes, Shishira. Can you tell me another movie name which was actually a novel?
You can say.
Okay. Arnett, can you answer the same? Raise your hand if you can answer. Manasmanya, please sit straight. Okay, we are all paying attention. And this is just second period. Shishira, now you can tell the answer.
BFG.
BFG, correct. The big friendly giant. Good. And also Harry Potter. Again, Himesh.
Ma'am, Journey to the Center of the Earth.
Correct. So there are many novels based on which many films are made. Similarly, based on his book, The Lord of the Rings, a series of movies made. This extract describes the hobbits and one of the hobbits, Bilbo Baggins' house. So let's read the passage. Who wish to read loudly? Raise hand if you can read loudly and very nicely. Who is confident to read? Okay, Ridvik. Ridvik, you can read the first paragraph.
Okay, ma'am. John read. Yule Tolkien has born in 1892. The born
start from the passage. Ridvik, start from the passage.
Ma'am?
In a hole in the ground, there lived a hobbit. From here.
Okay, ma'am. In a hole in the ground, there lived a rabbit.
Hobbit.
Rabbit.
It's hobbit.
Hobbit. Hobbit, not a nasty, dirty, wet hole filled with a end of worms and rosy smell or yet a dry, bare, sandy hole with nothing in it to sit down on or to tell it it was a hobbit hole, and that means comfort.
Okay, thank you. So what is the meaning of this part? In a hole in the ground there lived a hobbit. So the story starts with a description of a hobbit hole. So when we heard the word hole, what comes in our mind? There should be some muddy smell and it should be very nasty and wet. If you dig a hole in the ground, what will get out from there? A lot of nasty mud and a smell, bad smell, or maybe some worms also, right? This is monsoon season. If you go to your garden and start digging hole, you'll see all these things. But when it comes to a hobbit's hole, it is totally different. It means comfort. It is as comfortable as a person's house. Okay. Now, let's read the next. Who is interested to read now? Himesh. Only Himesh is paying a lot of energy. What about others?
It has a perfectly round door like a porthole, painted green with a shiny yellow brass knob in the exact middle. The door opens onto a tube-shaped hall like a tunnel, a very comfortable tunnel without smoke, with paneled walls, pegs for hats and coats. The hobbit was fond of visitors. The tunnel wound on, going fairly but not quite straight into the side of the hill. The hill, as all the people for miles around called it, and many little round doors opened out of it, first on one side.
Stop here. Okay, first on one side and then on another. So how hobbit's holes are? It is like a huge tunnel and it has a portal type door with a doorknob, and the color is green, and the inside is very well furnished because hobbits like visitors. They often meet each other. Okay, and the holes are connected to each other. It has two doors, one open inside and other door opens on the another. Okay. Now, Shishira, you would like to read next?
Yes, ma'am. On one side and then on another, no going upstairs for the hobbit. Bedrooms, bathrooms, cellars, pantries, lots of these wardrobes. He had whole room devoted to the clothes, kitchen, dining rooms.
Yes, all were on the same floor. Indeed, on the same passage. Okay, thank you, Shishira. So, how hobbits hole were? It had only one floor. No first floor, second floor, third floor, like that. And everything they had there, dining room, bathroom, kitchen, and everything, pantries. Pantries means kitchen, wardrobes. In fact, they had a separate room for a lot of clothes. Maybe hobbits are fond of fashion, right? But the design is everything was present in the same passage. As it is a hole, not a multi-story building.
Yes.
Now next, who is willing to read next? Okay. Yes, Vishwath, you can read next. The best rooms.
We know. Wait.
The best rooms were all inside.
Please mute yourself, okay? While Vishwath is reading, mute yourself. Yes, we should continue.
The best rooms were all on the left-hand side, going in, for these were the only ones to have windows. Deep set, round windows looking over his garden. The and meadows beyond sloping down to the river. This hobbit was a very well-to-do hobbit. And his name was Baggins. Baggins have lived in neighborhood of the hill for time out of mind, and people consider them very respectable, not only because most of them were rich, but also because they never had any adventures or did anything unexpected. You could tell what Baggins would say on any question without the brother of asking him. This is a
so,
and found himself doing yes, and
stop. Thank you. Stop. You can stop here. Let's explain this part. So this hobbit are very well-to-do hobbit. What is the meaning of well-to-do? Raise hand if you know the answer. Nobody knows. Well-to-do.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What is the meaning of well-to-do? Okay. Lasya knows. Lasya, tell me the answer. What is the meaning of well-to-do? Yes, Lasya.
You should do well.
Not do well. Actually, the meaning of well-to-do is rich, quite affluent and rich. That's why their houses were so good. And the best rooms had windows through which they could see the meadows beyond the sloping down. Now, let's read the next part. This is a story of how Baggins had an adventure. Read from here. Who is willing to read now? Raise your hand.
What, ma'am?
Who is willing to read from here? This is a story of how Baggins had an adventure. We'll read now page number 99. Okay, only 2 minutes, 15, 20, 12 minutes left. Nishruth read already. I want to see a new face. Who can read now? Siri, can you read? Siri, are you confident to read? Yes, Siri, can
ma'am,
you read from here? Page number 99.
Page number
99, from beginning.
Ma'am, a wisdom of words.
I guess Siri needs time to take out the book. Who can read now? Manaswini, can you read this passage now? Start from page number 99. Be prompt, everyone. Be ready with your book. Unmute first. What happened? No response. She should have already read. I want to... Ashank wants to read. Okay, Ashank, first you turn on the camera. Then start reading, okay? Ashank, turn on your camera. Yuvan, Vaishali, can you read from here, page number 99? Okay, Ashank raised hand. Ashank, continue now.
and found himself doing and saying things altogether unexpected. He may have lost the neighbor's respect, but he gained. Well, you will see whether he gained anything in the end.
So, okay, stop here. So, before we read the adventure story, we have to know in the story, the hobbit named, what is the name of the hobbit? Baggins, B-A-G-G-I-N-S. We have to remember the name of the hero, okay? Our hero is Baggins. So, Baggins had an adventure. And doing so, he did something very unexpected and he spoke something very unexpected, through which he could lost all his fame or respect he gained from his neighbors, or he could earn. So the author said, now the readers, that means we have to decide whether he gained something or he lost at the end. Let's now the story begins. Now continue reading. The mother of a particular hobbit.
The mother of a particular hobbit. Who was a hobbit? I suppose hobbits need some description nowadays, since they have become rare and shy of the big people, as the callers. They are a little people, about our height and smaller than...
About half of our height. Half of our
height and smaller than the bearded dwarf.
Yes.
Hobbits have beards. There is little or no magic about them, except that ordinary every sort which helps them to disappear quietly and quickly. When large stupid folk like you and me come blundering along, making a noise like elephants, which they can hear a mile off, they are inclined to be fat in the stomach. They dress in bright colors, chiefly green and yellow, wear no shoes because their feet grow natural leathery soles and thick warm brown hair like the stuff on their heads, which is curly, have long clever brown fingers, good natured faces, and laugh deep fruity laughs, especially after dinner, which they have twice when they can get it. Now you know enough to go on with. As I was saying, the mother of his
Okay, stop. So before the story, the author gave a description of the hobbit. Do I need to explain it? Everyone understood how hobbits look? If you didn't understand, you can show me thumbs down. I can explain in very simple words. Okay, Vishrut understood. Okay, so let's give a summary of this part. How hobbits look. Hobbits are just half of our size. I guess you are 10 or 11 years old, right? And almost 3 to 4 feet is your height, right? Then a hobbit child would be of your age, 2 feet only. Just imagine half of your size. If you were a hobbit, you could be like your 3-year-old brother. And they had curly hair, and also they have hair in their feet. And they never wear shoes. We need shoes, right? And you need different types of shoes for different purpose, like running shoes, walking shoes, and party shoes, right? And for traditional dresses, we have a pair of shoes. And formal, we have different pair of shoes. But unlike human beings, hobbits don't need to wear any shoes because their skin on the feet is very thick. And they're very quick to move. And they often hide from people like us, and they call us big people. And hobbits love to wear colorful dresses, especially green and yellow. This is the description of the hobbit. And one more thing I missed. Hobbit have a large belly. They have belly fat. Okay, this is how hobbits look. Now continue the story.
Bilbo Baggins.
Okay.
That is.
Frank read a lot. Now I want someone new to read. Who haven't read yet? Raise your hand. Act smart, students. Turn on your camera and raise hand. I think everyone can read nicely. Rachel, can you read now? Unmute, please. Unmute, Rachel.
Ma'am, my book is my. Yesterday, my teaching master said she will prepare notes for me.
But why you are telling me about your tuition master?
No, she's going to prepare notes.
You don't need any note for this poem. What we are going to do, we'll take 1 or 2 days and we'll read this story very nicely. Okay, don't worry about note. Mostly what we'll do, in my class, we'll read the story thoroughly, line by line I'll describe, and then we'll discuss the questions. Okay, verbally we'll complete as many questions as possible. And I will discuss with you for possible ending and other all kind of questions. And still if you need note, then I'll give you note. Don't worry. So let's complete the story first. So Rachel, can you read from here?
No, ma'am. Yesterday, my tuition master took the books.
Oh, you don't have book. Okay, fine. No problem. Who have book? Raise hand. I think Manaswini have book. Manaswini, can you read? Read loudly, Manaswini. Unmute first. Press the unmute button, Manaswini. Good. Now read from here. As I was saying, the mother of this hobbit. Read from here. Manaswini, first unmute. I guess Manaswini is having some technical problem. Dia, can you read?
I'm from where?
From the middle of the paragraph, as I was saying, the mother of this hobbit.
The mother of a particular hobbit.
Yes, read from here.
I'm from there only.
Yes.
What's the hobbit? I suppose hobbits need some description of it. Since they have become the direct child of the big people, as they call us.
Dear, your voice is breaking. Dear is not audible properly. Who can answer? Who can read next? Raise your hand first. Raise your hand quickly. Okay, Shishira. Yes, Shishira, continue.
I'm from there, ma'am.
As I was saying, the mother of this hobbit. Bilbo Baggins, that is, was the famous...
The mother of a particular, ma'am, from there only?
No, from the middle. We have read all this part. Description part is over. Now come to the middle.
No, ma'am, I can't.
Come to line number 17. Thirteen. Line number 13.
Now you can.
Yes, now you know.
I was saying the mother of this hobbit, Bilbo Baggins, that he's was a famous Bilandona, took one of the three remarkable daughters of the old fox, head of the hobbits, who lived across the water, the small river that ran at the foot of the hill. It was often set in other families the long ago. One of the two ancestors must have taken a fairy wife. That was, of course, absurd, but centrally there was still something not entirely hobbit-like about them, and once in a while members of the Hook clan would go and have adventures. They discreetly discovered, and the family hushed it up, but the fact remained that the Dukes were not as the Baggins.
As respectable as the Baggins. Yes, though they were undoubtedly richer. So we'll finish here. Tomorrow we'll read the rest of the story. So far the story is interesting. Show me thumbs up if you find the story interesting. Okay, have you understood what hobbit is? What kind of creature hobbit is, and how do they look? Very good. So many thumbs up. So we are closing here. Tomorrow we'll read rest of the story. So read up to here, page number 98 and page number 99. Keep reading and learn the hard word meaning. Though there is very less hard words, read it properly. Okay. And tomorrow okay. I want new students to read the rest of the story. So be prepared. So thank you for attending the class. Stay safe, drink a lot of water. Bye-bye for today.